大家好，欢迎回到这一期的李林说。上一期呢，我们跟大家解释了这个区域划分的来源和它到底是怎么运用在现实生活中的。今天呢，我们就跟大家揭秘老侯呀所有就是当地居民比较喜欢的一些餐厅。大家都知道，即使我们在中国去旅游的时候，虽然我们在网上可以查到很多适合游客去的一些比较有名的餐厅，但是呢，其实最最最地道的那些餐厅呢，都是只有当地人才知道的。所以呢，今天这一期呢，千万不要错过。
Let me tell you about the restaurants. Now, this is the restaurants where the locals go. So don't tell anybody. This is a secret. The first one is George's, level two. George's is one of our best restaurants in La Jolla. And many people eat down in the lower section, which is very elegant, or they go up on the terrace. But the locals go to level two. It's a little more casual, and the food is delicious.Level two is similar to the upper levels. They have grilled salmon and various plates on the bottom. They also have delicious grilled fish tacos, which are very good. And you can sit right on the edge of the world and look at the ocean below you.
大家都知道老侯爷很有名的一个餐厅叫 George's， 可是呢，我们游客呢，就是一般去的呢，都是它的一楼和它顶层这个天台。但是其实当地人最享受的呢，是它的二楼。所以如果您有机会去这个餐厅的话，一定要去二楼尝一尝。如果大家去那里不知道点什么呢，可以点他的烤鱼，还有烤鱼做的 taco， 算是他那里比较特色的一些小吃。
The second restaurant is right down the street, Eddie V's, and most people again go to the lower level wherever all the tourists are, but the locals go upstairs on the rooftop. And also it has delicious food, but the main thing is,You're up there with the locals, and you can see the ocean and the birds flying by. It just feels really good to be there.
第二个推荐的餐厅呢，就是 Eddie V's。Eddie V's 也是这边比较有名的一个餐厅。然后一般游客呢，只知道去它的大厅，却不知道它上面还有一个，可以观景看海的天台。所以下次大家去这个餐厅的时候，可以去顶层看一下。我给大家推荐的一个是龙虾做的 taco， 还有一个呢就是蟹肉饼。而且特别要记得去他们的天台。
Next one is Cody's, and it's a locals restaurant.Because it used to be down below, and now it's up on another level, again, another place with an amazing view. It's American food, and they also have the delicious grilled salmon as well in the evening, as well as some other, the desserts are sweet. I really like they have a cheesecake that has a slight glaze on the top. It's delicious.
第三个跟大家推荐的餐厅呢是 Cody's， 这个餐厅呢我自己也没有去过。这个餐厅呢现在的新的地理位置呢，它也有一个可以欣赏海景的天台。如果去它这里，如果你想尝到非常正宗的美式早餐的话，那就可以去这里尝一尝。还有呢，就是千万不要错过它这里做的甜品，尤其是乳酪蛋糕。
And there's two restaurants right across the street from each other. One is Brick and Bell, and one is Parakeet Cafe. Brick and Bell has delicious coffee. It's a coffee place. I love their oatmeal raisin cookies. There's some other all sorts of scones, delicious. And you sit outside, and it just feels like you're part of the community. In Parakeet Cafe across the street, it's mostly girls, mostly women go there.Because the food is delicious, they have smoothies, mostly organic food. The waffles are good. Avocado toast, because everybody eats avocado toast.
第四个跟大家推荐的呢，是推荐给喜欢喝咖啡的人。一个是 Brick and Bell， 一个呢是 Parakeet Cafe。这一般当地的人呢非常喜欢这两个地方，而且呢很多人都喜欢坐在外面聊聊天呀什么的。所以如果您是咖啡爱好者的话，可以去尝一尝。如果你是追寻健康的女士的话呢，那我推荐您去那个 Parakeet Coffee， 因为这里呢，它所有的东西一般都是有机的，而且呢，热量也都比较低。如果您去 Parakeet Coffee 的话，我建议您尝一尝他们做的这个牛油果吐司，也就是 Avocado Toast， and 还有他们的 Waffle 华夫饼。
The other one is called The Lot, and it's a movie theater with many, many movie theaters, and outside is the dining area. And by the way, you go Tuesday nights, there's a live band there, it's Big Taco Tuesday, and it's a lot of fun because people dance all night and just have a great time. And you can tell them about Wednesday night too, that's when you get a special deal.
下一个跟大家推荐的当地人非常喜欢的这个地方呢叫 The Lot， 大家如果大家想来试一试它这里的饮食的话，那我建议您周二晚上来，因为它除了可以在这里吃吃喝喝之外呢，它每个周二晚上还有 live band， 然后呢大家还可以在这跳舞。嗯，他们这里的舞呢 大部分都是类似salsa 还有拉丁舞一类的。大家都知道 The Lot 也是一个看电影的比较高端的一个电影院，可是它每周三呢都有惊喜，所以呢如果您想来这里看电影可以周三来试一试。
El Pescador is our last restaurant, very much a locals restaurant, all the surfers, that's where they work, and it started across the street as a small cafe, and it's gotten bigger and bigger, and what they do there, everything is fresh caughtYou can see the fish lined up. You can buy fresh fish if you like, or smoked fish. And then they also take this fresh fish right from the boats and grill it for you. They also have different dishes. And it's really a delicious place, casual, and also has great beer.
最后一个跟大家推荐的当地人很喜欢的网红餐厅呢，就是 El Pescador。如果您非常喜欢海鲜的话呢，千万不要错过这个餐厅，因为它这里提供的所有的海鲜呢都是很新鲜的，都是从海里刚刚打上来的。而且您除了可以在这边吃饭之外呢，还可以买一些新鲜的生鱼回去自己来煮。这里还有一个特色呢，就是它的啤酒。如果您是爱好啤酒的男士呢，可以来这边尝一尝。下一期呢我们继续回到地产上来，因为现在很多人呢他都对这个都知道这边老后呀，因为他很多房子都很老，一不小心呢就会接触到这个历史建筑，所以下一期呢跟大家好好解释一下美国这边的历史建筑。我们下期见，再见。